Hey guys, this is going to be a video replacing the inner windshield molding. Sorry about my voice, I'm a little sick. So not the outer here, but the inner felt that's going along here. You can't even see it yet. I'm going to remove the door panel. If you need any assistance with that, you can review the focal video that's a couple back there, which shows how to remove the door panel. Once I have the door panel off, you'll be able to see the molding. And I'll show you the little defect in mine, which is causing a squeak right around this area as the window reaches the top and bottom. So I got it inner molding ordered. Going to see how easy that is to pop on. So let me show you here. I got the door panel off. It is not the... Let me hang up this light. Okay. I'm not talking about this bead here, that's straight. I'm talking about the inner bead. You can see here, this felt touching the window. You probably can't see here. Let me get you a close-up. It's a little rippled along the window where it dips down here. That's what I want to show you. That's why I'm replacing it. You can barely see it, but I definitely know that it's nice and flush along the window, and you can see little bumps there. What happened was I found this section of the seal right about in the last section here was folded over on the window, all bent down. I did manage to pull it back up, but you can see it's all deformed and pressing in different pressures here along the window, and sometimes it'll squeak. Just to make sure that it's not a real issue, I'm going to go ahead and replace that molding, which I think is this entire piece. It includes this little felt piece of it here. I think it's all one piece that pops right off. I'm going to look at the new one before I yank on this and break some. Like usual, I didn't wait for my own instructions. It pulls right out. I just pulled it straight up. There's no bolts on this thing. Perfect. So this is your inner seal that hugs that window right there. And you can see here, this goes right here, tucks into the side of the window, and the edges snug up right there and right there against the seal, right, real nice. So if I take this out here, oh man, this is the source of all my noise. I didn't see this. Let me show you this in the light. I could only see this upper level from top, and I fixed it. This whole thing was still bent. See that? That is the squeak I'm hearing, as the window would just not like that. So hope my new one should be all flat and flush. That's sweet, because that's definitely going to solve the problem now that I saw it. You can't see this until you take it out. That's a good find. So I just got the new piece in. You can see here the malformed one and the normal one is just kind of flat and flush. Looks like it's the right piece. Let's go ahead and see if we can get it tucked in there. Oh my god, that's so easy. It's so killer. I love when an install is just right. It hugs the window a lot more. That's all you do. I'm glad that's solved. Now I can put the door back together. Just for reference, I also got 5 of the airbag trims. Just a nice piece to have around. Anytime you do A-pillar work, the legs can snap off a little bit. So it's always good to have a few spare airbag clips there. The airbag clip is 1K0853437B71N, is in Nancy. And these are about $3 each. Even more important is your door clips. I went ahead and ordered a 12-pack. You can see the part number right there. Anytime, you know, every time I take off this panel, this inner lower clip is always the one that breaks. So it's just strange, none of the other ones break. But it's good to have a big old stash, then you're just set for the life of the car pretty much.